हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज अनिल राज, वेलकम टू विट्स वरंगल। इन द प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम्स वी हैव सीन मूमेंट एरिया मेथड। इन द मूमेंट एरिया मेथड हाउ मेनी केसेस आर देर? सिक्स केसेस आर देर। वी हैव सीन ऑल द सिक्स केसेस एंड वी हैव सॉल्व सम ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स इन मूमेंट एरिया मेथड। एंड टुडेज टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मैकॉलेस मेथड। Why this method is called as Michaelis method? In the sense, this method was devised by Mr. W. H. Macaulay. Yes, because of this scientist name, we got this Michaelis method. And why we have to use Michaelis method? Because we are having one more method, that is moment area method. And why we are using, in the sense, actually this is advanced method of moment area method. Yes, in the moment area method, when the loads are increasing, it is difficult to find out the exact bending moment and exact slope of the given problem. Yes, so by this Michaelis method, what we can do, in the sense, in the single term, we can find out the answers. So let us see some of the rules of the Michaelis method. Rule number one: take the origin on the extreme left of the beam. It means, for example, when you are taking a simply supported beam, it contains a load. Now, whatever the number of loads which are there, that should be taken, and whatever the point which you are taking should be, that will be extreme left. So here you have to consider, it means you have to consider the moment about this x, and you have to find out the bending moment equation, and you have to derive the expressions so that you will get a bending moment equation by substituting the exact values of these wherever the load which you are calculating, there you can get the bending moment. For example, here I am having W1, here it is W2, that may be W3, whatever the loads which is there. So by taking x at moment about the x, I'll get all the loads under this. So what happened, in the sense, I'll get the maximum bending moments by taking the distances of this, right? So take the origin on the extreme left of the beam, and next one is write down the expression of the bending moment in the last portion of the beam to the right by taking the all the forces and reactions acting towards the left. It means we have to consider, for example, this is W, this is W, right? This is Wx, let this be Wy. Adding of W1 plus W2 plus W3, I got Wx at this side, Wy at that side. So the moment which I have to take, Wx into x distance, let this distance be x, and this be L1, L2, L3. For example, these are the lengths of L1, L2, L3. Now the moment which will be generated at x will be Wx into x, and up to this portion I am considering. So these loads will also comes under this portion. So W1 into x minus L1. So you will get this portion. W2 into x minus L2. W3 into x minus L3. You will get these portions. So like that, you have to calculate the moments. And let's see, integrate the term such as x minus a in the form of x minus a whole square by 2, and not as x square by a minus ax. See, whatever this we are doing, this is done in mathematics, but coming to the mechanics, x minus a should be considered as a single term. In the mass, how we will consider, in the sense, x is one term, a is one term, so that's why x square by a minus ax, like that you will get. But in the Michaelis method, x minus a is termed as only single term, that will be x. X minus a will be represented with x. What is x square, in the sense, x square by x, in the sense, x square by 2. So like that, x minus a whole square will be also treated as a single term. So these are some of the basic rules, and let us see some of the basic definitions as well as the basic methods how to solve this. By taking a simply supported beam with central point load, we will solve an equation and we will find out the maximum bending moment by using Michaelis method. So let us see that, and let's see a standard case. So this is the standard case. I'm having a simply supported beam. This is A, this is B, where I'm having a load of W at the central point load. Let this be L by 2 and L by 2, right? For this we have to find out the maximum slope and deflection by using Michaelis method, right? So this is my method. So sorry, this is my problem. Find the slope and deflection of a simply supported beam with central point load by using Michaelis method. Now let's see how to find out. So before going for that, actually according to the rules we have to consider the x distance. Let this be x. So I have to consider the moment about the x. Therefore, moment about x, the moment which is generated about x, is equal to, so this is W, so it is a symmetrical beam. So at A you will get W by 2 and at B you will get W by 2. And my moment about x, the moment about x which will be generated will be W by 2 into x, because this distance is x. I'm considering here, so that's why W by 2 into x, right? So upward load will be always positive, or vice versa, whatever you take, and download load will be negative, and one more load which is coming from the top. So this is coming from the top forward direction, downward direction, so it is minus W into x minus L by 2. So this is my bending moment which will be respected with x. Moment about x is generated W by 2 into x minus W into x minus L by 2. So this is my moment. Now let us find out, according to the Michaelis method, this can be written as d square y by dx square is equal to mx. So what is my mx? Moment about x, it is here. So this is d square y by dx square is equal to W by 2 into x minus W into x minus L by 2. So this is my bending moment equation. And why I have plotted a dotted line, in the sense whatever the loads which are there, the load should be separated individually, and after integrating you will get a constant, that is C1 or C2 at the last. But according to the Michaelis rule, that constant term should be added at first point, right? Now let us integrate. So if you integrate, so let this be taken as 1. If you integrate this, you will get the slope equations. So I'm writing here, integrating equation number 1 to get slope equation, right? I'll get one slope equation. So integration of d square y by dx square will be dy by dx, that is dy by dx is equal to, and now integration of W by 2 into x is nothing but wx square by 2. So 2 into 2, again you will get 4. So here W by 2 into integration of x will be x square by 2, right? and at the last actually you will get a constant, but according to the Macaulay's rule, the constant should be added over here. Plus C1 is my constant term, right? So this is first load, upward load, and downward load you are having one more load, that is minus W into X minus L by 2. So I am writing here minus W into X minus L by 2 whole square by 2. Let this equation be 2. And here also he said that, and in the rules also we discussed that X minus L should be taken as a single term, not X square minus L by 2 whole square like this, right? So this total will be considered as only single term. So this is my slope equation. Now I have to get a deflection equation. How I get deflection? If I integrate the slope equation, then I'll get the deflection equation. Simple. Now integrating equation number 2 to get deflection, right? It means again we have to integrate the slope equation to get the deflection. So I am integrating here. What is dy by dx integration is y is equal to w by 2 whole square, in the sense I can multiply this, so it will become w by 4. Here it is x square, so it will become x cube by 3, right? Next integration of c1 will be c1x, and for the c1 constant again you will get c2 one more term. And similarly you have to integrate this also, so minus w into x minus l by 2 whole cube by 3 into 2, 6. So this is equation number 3. So you got equation, slope equation, you got deflection equation. And what you have to do in the sense, here c1 and c2s are the constants. C1 and C2 are the constants. You have to eliminate C1 and C2 terms by applying boundary conditions. So let us see how to apply the boundary conditions. So here I am applying boundary conditions. B is in the sense boundary conditions. What are the boundary conditions? Let us see first. For example, we have taken a simply supported beam now. I am taking a simply supported beam with the central point load W. Here we are having two boundaries. We are having two boundaries. One is at A, next one is at B. If I want the first boundary condition, it means if I want the boundary at A, then at x equal to 0, y equal to 0. At x equal to 0, y equal to 0. Here my x is nothing but my distance. Where my distance becomes 0, then automatically my deflection will also becomes 0, because if it is a simply supported beam, the bending moment of the bending moment diagram will be like this. See, here there is no deflection. Here there is no deflection. At x equal to 0, y equal to 0, that is first boundary conditions. And next boundary is at this point, is at B point. So at x equal to, what is this distance? It is this distance is called as L distance, right? At x equal to L, what is y? Again 0. Again 0. At x equal to L, y equal to 0. So these are the two boundary conditions we have to apply. In which equation? Where I'll get y? In this deflection equation. So in this equation I have to supplement these boundary conditions to eliminate c1 and c2 constants. So let us see, I am applying at x equal to 0, y equal to 0, right? In equation number 3, if I take this equation at x equal to 0, what is y here? Y will become 0, therefore 0 is equal to W by 4 into x cube by 3. What is x here? Again 0. So I'm substituting W by 4 into what is x here? 0 cube by 3 plus c1x plus c2. So c1 into x is 0 plus c2. So I have substituted in case I have substituted equation number in the equation number 3, that is x equal to 0, y equal to 0. Now let us see here at y that became 0, w by 4 0 by something, in the sense this term will become 0 and this term became 0. Therefore what is c2? The value of c2 will becomes 0, right? So the condition is, therefore at x equal to 0, y equal to 0, c2 is equal to 0. You got one boundary conditions. It means this boundary conditions. Now I have to apply the second boundary conditions. Where I have to apply my second boundary conditions? At a distance of x equal to L. X equal to L only, I'll get the deflections, because when I am substituting in this equation only, only y is nothing but my deflection. So that's why I have to go at this boundary conditions. Now I am substituting at x equal to L, y equal to 0. So these are the boundary conditions. Now put these boundary conditions in equation number 3 again. Previously also I have substituted in equation number 3, I got c2 value as 0. Now I am applying the same but at x equal to L. So let us see what is my y. Again I am substituting here, y is 0, so it is 0. So w by 4 into x in the sense I have to substitute L. So I can write that like this, 4 into 3, 12. I am writing here w by 12 into, that is L now. So L cube. In case of x, just I am putting my value of L. So I got w by 12 into L cube plus c1 into x plus c1 into x in the sense, again L plus c2. What is c2? I got the value of c2 here, so it is 0 obviously. And next one more term is there, because when I am going to a distance of L, this load is also coming, this load is also coming, upward load and downward load. In the previous problem only upward load you got, you have not taken the downward load, because the load the point is at only at x distance, so that's why I didn't consider this load. When I am moving away from this, so this load is also coming, so you have to consider this load also. So I am considering that load. So minus w into x in the sense l minus l by 2 whole cube by 6. L minus l by 2 in the sense, again l by 2 whole cube. So I am solving this, so this is wl cube by 12 plus c1l, this is 0, okay, minus l minus l by 2 will be l by 2. So w by 6 into l by 2 whole cube. So wl cube 2 cube 8 into 6 48. So I got here wl cube by 12 plus c1l minus wl cube by 48, w into l cube, wl cube. So here 2 cube will be 8 into 6 48. So wl cube by 48. Again I have to solve this equation. Now I am taking this equation, that is wl cube by this and this. I have to find out c1 from this, so I have to find out c1 in the sense. So I am taking this term to this side and this term to this side, so I'll get only c1 terms. So when this is minus, when it comes to this side, it will become plus. So here c1l equal to wl cube by 48 minus wl cube by 12. It means I am sending both these terms to opposite side. So negative became positive, positive became negative. So C1L equal to WL cube by 48 minus WL cube by 12. So I'm solving this. Again, I have to take LCM of this. So C1L is equal to LCM of 48 and 12 will be 48. 48 ones are 48, so WL cube minus 12 threes are 12, sorry, 12 fours are 48. So 4 a WL cube, so minus 4 WL cube by 48. Again, W minus 3 will be C1L is equal to minus 3 WL cube by 48, right? Still we can cancel this. 3 ones are 3, 16s are 48. So C1L is equal to minus WL cube by 16. So I want only C1, I don't want again L from this. So what I have to do, I'm sending this L to numerator, so it will becomes into denominator. So this L and here L get cancelled, so it will become minus WL square by 16. Therefore, C1 value will be C1 is equal to minus WL square by 16. So this is one more, this is one more equation. So this is one more boundary conditions. So now I got C2 value and I got C1 values. I got both boundaries, C1 and C2s. Now what I have to do in the sense, I have to apply both C1 and C2 values in bending moment equation 3 to get the maximum bending equations. So we'll substitute. So after getting C1 and C2 boundary conditions, I have to substitute in this equation. In which equation? In equation number 3. What is my equation number 3? EI into Y equal to WX cube by 12 plus C1X plus C2 minus W into X minus L by 2 whole cube by 6. This is equation number 3. Now, in these 3, C1 and C2 values has to be substituted because I got C1 value, I got C2 values, right? So I'm substituting EA into Y equal to WX cube by 12. What is value of C1? What I got is minus WX minus WL square by 12 that I have substituted, plus C2 values. Here X is missing, sorry, X, okay, plus C2. What is the value of C2? C2 is 0, that we got already the boundary conditions. Yes, I have substituted 0 for that, and this remaining I have written. So let this be equation number 4. So this is my equation with respect to slope and deflection with boundary conditions. Equation number 2 and 3 are without boundary conditions. Equation number 4 I got with boundary conditions. So whatever the slope I want, whatever the deflection I want, from this equation I'll get. So if I want to find out the maximum bending moment, where I'll get the maximum bending moment for the simply supported with the central point load? Definitely at center. So I have to substitute at x equal to L by 2. At a distance of x equal to L by 2, I'll get the maximum deflection. So in this equation, I have to substitute L by 2. When I substituted L by 2, I'll get the maximum deflection equation very easily. So let us try to find out the maximum deflection. To find maximum deflection, put x equal to L by 2. So I have to substitute x equal to L by 2 in that equation. So EI into Y equal to W by 2. In case of X, I have to put L by 2. So L by 2 whole cube 0 into X. In the place of L, L by 2 whole cube. Okay, this is over. And next, minus WL square by 16 into X. So WL square by 16 into X. What is X again? L by 2. I have to substitute. Let's solve this. So this is WL cube by 2 cube 8, 8 into 12. It is 96 minus WL cube by 32. so this is my equation. This equation I have to solve it again. So let's solve this. So this is LCM 96. I have to take in 96 ones are 96. So 1 into WL cube. So this is WL cube, right? So I got minus over here. So I have taken minus. So 32 threes are 96. So minus 3 WL cube. So I got, after doing the LCM of this, I got WL cube minus 3WL cube my 96. Now here I'm having 1, so it is minus 2WL cube by 96. So again I can cancel 2 1s are 2 48s are, so it is minus WL cube by 48. What is that equation? EI into Y, no? So EI into Y. So I want only Y. It means maximum deflection. Maximum deflection will occur at C point. So I can write like this. Y C equal to minus WL cube by 48 EI. This is the maximum deflection of a simply supported beam with a center point load, that is minus WL cube by 48 EI. Minus sign indicates the deflection will act towards the downward direction, right?